Okay, so we're going to talk about three of the problems from the homework on page 118 to 119. Make sure you correct your work along with me. So let's look at problem 41 on page 118. And so I need to solve for r. So first of all, I'm going to simplify each side of the equation. So I'm going to use the distributive property first. So 6r, and that would be minus 4 plus 2r, is equal to 8r minus 4. Now, I notice on the left side of the equation, I have some like terms, so I'm going to simplify once more. So now I have 8r minus 4 equals 8r minus 4. Now, you notice both sides of the equation are equal, and it's a true statement. That's why they're equal. So if ever you simplify a problem, like, for example, if I did one more step here, if I subtract 8r from and minus 8r from both sides, I end up with negative 4 equals negative 4. So what that is telling me, that no matter what value I use for r, this equation is true. So then the solution then is that it would be all real numbers. Now your book says identity in the back. That means the same thing. Any number I choose will make this equation true. Now let's go on to one of our word problems. Let's look at number 10. Now number 10, notice I've already filled in a couple of the pieces of information. The question is, what is the mass of each ball? And then the facts that I'm given is that we have six steel balls, and we know that they each have an equal amount of mass. And we're told that five balls are equal to one ball plus 100 grams. Now, they gave us a diagram in the book, so you know what? I actually think I do not need any other strategy but writing an equation. But first, before I write an equation, I must always define the variable. So I'm going to let x represent the mass of one ball. Now that I've defined the variable, I'm going to write an equation. So I have five balls, so five groups of x is equal to one of the balls plus 100. Now I'm going to solve for the mass of one ball. So I'm going to subtract x from both sides using the subtraction property of equality, and I have 4x equals 100, and then when I divide by both sides using the division property of equality, I find out that the mass of one ball is 25. Now make sure you check. Are your units correct? So we must have grams. And also when I check, does 5 times 25, is that equivalent to 25 plus 100? Well, yes, 125 equals 125. And I would write my complete sentence saying the mass of one ball is 25 grams. Now let's do the last word problem that you had to do. What is the length and width? So we have a rectangle, we are told in the problem, and the facts we're given is that the length is twice the width, and we know that the perimeter is 84 more than the value of the width. Now I'm going to help myself by drawing and labeling a diagram, because I'm not quite ready to go to the equation. So I'm going to let W represent width, and I'll label the diagram accordingly, and we're told that the length is twice the width, so therefore, the length will be 2 times W, and I'm going to label my diagram accordingly. Okay, so I've used this fact, now let's use the last fact, the perimeter. Well, I know perimeter is the sum of all sides, so I have the two widths plus the two lengths, and I'm told that it is 84 more than, we know that implies addition, more than the width. So now I will solve for width. Now I'm going to let you do the solving part because I'm sure you're pretty good at that. And when you do the mathematics, you're going to end up with the width. Sorry, I had to check the answer here. The width is 33.6. And so twice that would be the length, which is, oh, excuse me, I got that incorrect. Let me change that. The width is, go back to pen mode. The width is 16.8 centimeters. And then the length is 33.6 centimeters. Okay, so check the units. We must use centimeters. And then you can check the values into the original equation.